this next question is for Pastor Chavez. What evidence is there that Jesus is returning?
Well, first of all, if you look at all the global things that are going on in the world, just as early as you had asked the question, where is there peace? Is that when we have so much tragedy? Well, God has given a promise that he would bring the real peace, because man has been over 2,000 years, and yet they still cannot come up with even knowing how to love one another. They can't even have real peace. One minute they say they have peace, and the next minute they turn on you. And we know that there is a promise, as we can see by the signs of the time, that the world is getting more catastrophic events that are happening, that global warming, earthquakes, fish is dying in the sea, birds dying in the air. Those are signs that God has promised, that has fulfilled, that are showing signs that there is going to be peace coming soon. The true peace.
Amen. God.
And Karen, tell me please, even if your Jesus Christ returns, what's the big deal?
Well, first part of that question, he will return, because he's not a man that he should lie, or a man that he should repent. He said he was coming again for those of you that are his. And he did come that everybody would have a chance to be saved. The big deal is that you better know who you serve. Because you don't know when your time is up. And if you haven't made that dedication to Christ as your Savior, then you choose where you are going to spend eternity.
That's right.
And once you die, the big deal is that it's over. Your choice is made. Yeah. So you better make sure that your choice is made and that you are going. And the big deal is that you will have everlasting life forever and ever without end. He will wipe away all your tears. No more sorrow, no more pain. And sir, the way you're addressing us as you Christians tells me that you really may not know the Lord. So I would suggest that you might want to say a sinner's prayer when we're done. And I'd be glad to do that with you.
This next question is for Pastor Tingley. Summing things up, how would you believers access the state of world affairs today?
I would say the world affairs today is what God and the scriptures have alluded to, that when Jesus comes, it will be as in the days of Noah. As in the days of Noah, people were doing all kinds of sin, disbelief of God, ridiculing a man of God, marrying, giving to marriage, going on with normal activities in life, and then the flood came. Jesus said that it will be in these days of world affairs now, that it will be just as in the day of Noah, that world activities will be, and it, people will be going along, and all of a sudden, he will come. The world affairs are really messed up right now, and the only way to peace is through Jesus.
Pastor Ben, you are the senior pastor. Some say that the story of Noah is a myth. What do you think about that?
They can choose it to be a myth, but it's in the Bible, it's scripture. They have interviewed many countries and many leaders of countries.
They asked you, you could run into an accident. If you don't know Jesus Christ, You're eternally condemned. But if you happen to live and you make it, we're inviting you to come to a church that believes in the whole Bible, from Genesis to Revelations. We believe in the Old Covenant and the New Covenant. And we take very seriously loving our sheep. We love shepherding the Word of God. We love covering them and praying for them. And we call occasionally we try not to be a pest, but we love to call you all to let you know that we miss you, we love you, and we care for you. Because there's no one that cares for you more than we do, like Jesus Christ. And we're supposed to be an example on how we care for you. And we promise to tell the whole true doctrine of the Bible. Because in the last days, there will be doctrines of demons. There will be doctrines of men. And it's very important to know the truth. So if the day comes of persecution, you'll know what you believe and what you stand for.
Amen.
Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, fellow believers and honored guests, to our first dramatization television broadcast from World Restoration Fire Church.
Was true, and I believe it, and that you're living now as a promise. When they ask you, Jesus, who are you? Where is the resurrection? He says, I am the resurrection. Hallelujah. And Lord, I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior from this moment forward. Call it Easter Sunday, call it Resurrection Sunday, I call it He is Risen Day. Hallelujah. If anybody has a grief or a worry or a broken heart or a broken arm or a broken mind or a liver that's given a problem or a headache that won't go away, we can pray for you right here, right now. Hallelujah. Want me to read it?
Say He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is risen. Come.
is risen day. You are dismissed.
Hallelujah.